What's up, Meister Village, your boy Buckmeister, twice the nice that you are used to. Bam, we are here with the Funk Doc, the Funky Doc. We are here with the Funky Doc. We are here with Mr. Reggie Noble himself, Red Man. So, link is in the description down below. Please go check it out for yourself. 1990 now. Alright, even the name sound 1999. Even the name sound fire. Alright, so link in the description down below. Please go check it out. Let's go, Red Man. What's up? Oh, we're going. We're going back.
Paging Reggie Noble.
Man, he's one of the great. He's one of the greatest hip hop personalities. Not even MCs, just a hip hop personality. You know what I'm saying? Everything aviation. Feel like Clark and I'm on vacation. I throw it in park, now I'm back to basics. Who need teaching? I'm cocky, I'm reaching. It's ugly like when old ladies ain't decent. I don't like beefing, my weight like a vegan. But compared to y'all on the mic, you ain't eating. I ain't talking Lambos and F1s. More like Rakim and KRS-1s. I'm killing them, you can keep your money. A boss need a big guess. Is the right. Like, just as a hip-hop personality, he's one of the greatest. You know what I'm saying? Like, bigger than life and all of that stuff. Rush represent for New Jersey. Yo, finest. For every bar. The ass red man was the sound. I tell a motherfucker 1990 now. I love this groove also. And like, we have to talk about it lyrically. I feel like I would be talking forever. It'll be a 2-hour video if I have to talk about this lyrically. Like, oh, like, dude, listen to that line. With a packet of bills. What, man? Oh, come on. Come on.
Niggas hate that. Old niggas make that. That's like a Maybach built with an 8-track. Scrubs that get Ajax ASAP.
Who's DJ? Oh, okay. I thought I saw Lupe for a second. I was gonna be, my mind would have been like, games like Cowboys and Pittsburgh. When I was putting up Muddy Water stickers, she was a young cat trying to meet Big Bird. Oh, we for everybody. Sound, I tell a motherfucker 1990 now. Yeah, I said, clap your hands, everybody. Man, I love it. I love everything Red Man. I love everything Red Man puts out. Red Man is like that MC.
You said that shit already.
I did, right? God damn it. Bring it back. Yo, well, my camp on fire, Smokey the Bear. So only thing fading is mostly the hair. Got women clumsy like Sinclair and so many Jordans that nigga owe me a pair. I swear I can afford to take losses with all these exhausters on the horses. You won't find me up in the office when it's Friday and I want this. Yeah, I'm come pal around a sundown. I should be rich now like the Rothschilds. Rather, I'm in the hood with a black and mouth, listening to y'all demos and sound clouds. And you see,
everybody. But it's very clean compared to his old stuff. The sound, I say. Like, this is a very clean sound. Because Red Man, that a lot of people are used to, is very rugged and raw and very in your face and smash mouth. I don't know why I'm holding the mic. It's very smash mouth and everything. So, this is kind of clean. I guess that's what.
Yo, what the fuck? Who the fuck turned off the power?
What the fuck, man?
Fucking assholes.
Yeah, but I mean, it's very clean compared to regular Red Man sound. Like, regular Red, I'm guessing it's kind of what he's doing now. It's kind of like a clean version of the 90s hip-hop sound, which I don't have a problem with. I don't know why people have a problem with it. Like, that was one thing that I heard people complain about with the Wu-Tang Clan new album, 2017, The Saga Continues. It was like, they wanted the 36 Chambers all over again. But it's like, you're not going to get the 36 Chambers because when they did the 36 Chambers, they're different compared to, yeah, they're different from when they were doing the 36 Chambers. The men that did the 36 Chambers aren't the men that exist today. So, I mean, you can't expect The Saga Continues to bring you back to the 36 Chambers or even or even the other album. What was the name of the other album that they did? I can't remember what it was called. I remember some of the tracks on there, but I'm just trying to remember what it was called. Just give me a second. This is gonna bother me. This is going to bother me to no end. Wu-Tang Forever. Why was that so hard? Jeez. Yeah, Wu-Tang Forever. There we go. Anyway, I'm just saying, you're not going to get into the Wu-Tang from the 36 Chambers, and you're not going to get Wu-Tang Forever again. We had it. It was great. But these guys need to continue and progress. You know what I'm saying? So I loved The Saga Continues. I thought The Saga Continues was a great album. But getting back to my point is this sounds a lot cleaner than his regular sound. You know what I'm saying? I mean, lyrics is still on point and everything, but I mean, I'm not used to him having those kind of grooves. Like, it's kind of a soulful 90s groove, which I think is still cool. So, yeah, Reggie's still killing it. One of the most consistent, like, consistency for me is one thing. Because, Black Thought, consistency on point. A lot of the Wu-Tang Clan, consistency on point. MF Doom, consistency on point. Black Thought, consistency on point. You know what I'm saying? Eminem, he's getting consistent now, but I think it's his success kind of ruined his skill as an MC, if you guys kind of understand what I'm saying. Because I think there is a blessing in disguise in being underground and being hungry, that you are going to continue to rap your ass off. So when you reach numerous heights of success and you've been raw for a while, you run out of things to say. Whereas when you're underground, people don't know, so you have more room to be creative, I feel. Anyway, the Killer Mike ELP, dude, those dudes have been consistent. But anyway, yeah, so I love this video, I love this thing, and I love Redman. No homos. Pause. I love Redman. So anyway, if you guys like this video, please like, share, and subscribe. If you did not, that is your business. And I'll see you all in another video, because my segment's gotta be out. Peace.